Thank you. dog?
Thank you.
Thank you. Appeal after shave alone. Remember, never for evil.
Do you consider that some newspapers treat politics with a trace of bias? One side always right, the other side always wrong. Or the other way around. Today will show all politicians without bias, not as saints or devils, but ordinary people.
Hey, yeah! Order! Order!
Today colors the newspaper, not the news. Today, the newspaper that's broken the mold.
Once upon a time, there lived a man named Squidgy Bod. Everything he did was wrong. Everything he touched either broke or fused or tore. His clothes were either too big or too small. But everybody loved him. When he went out, dogs would lick him. Horses would wave their tails at him. And little children would follow him. There also lived a man called Thermus Fortitude. Everything he did was right. Thank you. But everybody hated him. When he went out, dogs would attack him. Horses would not wave their tails at him. And little children did not love him. In fact, nobody loved him. Except his stuffed alligator named Charlie. And so, Thermos would go home and cuddle Charlie, saying, "Why does nobody love me? Why does nobody love me? Why does nobody love me?" One day, Thermos saw an advertisement saying,
"I can make you be loved. Send 25 guineas for my course of instruction."
And so, every day, Thermos studied. Lesson 1, touch toes 300 times. Lesson 2, straighten nose. Lesson 3, be taller. Lesson 4, now go out and be loved. And so, Thermos went out, and everybody loved him. Dogs licked him. Horses waved their tails at him. And little children followed him. But his stuffed alligator, Charlie, hated him. Thermos took Charlie and shook him, saying,
"Love me, love 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 me, or I will throw you out of the window."
So he threw him out of the window, where he hit Squidgy Bod, who was walking by, not seeing where he was going, because his hat was too big. And the moral is,
when it comes to love, no one really has it.
Mini cheddars.
If you like cheese, you'll love these.
Where's Lord Cardigan?
To line, Lord Cardigan.
Light Brigade, with me.
What?
Hi, man. This is Cresta's new flavor, black currant. I wonder what's...
Timber!
Black currant flavor, huh? It's okay.
Cresta, not in five fruity flavors.
It's frothy, man.
Oh, blow the man down, bullies, blow the man down. Way, blow the man down. Blow the man down, bullies, blow the man down. Give me some time to blow the man down. The gale, she is running far out of the deep. Way, blow the man down. The lightning, it falls like a lash of the sea. Give me some time to blow the man down. The wind is a howling, a mountain of foam.
London. The time, 1843.
The season, that of jollity, of festivity and charity, holly and berries and goodwill to all men, with perhaps one exception. And it is with this exception that we are concerned in our story. The exception is Ebenezer Scrooge.
A Merry Christmas, Uncle! God save you!
Humbug.
Christmas a humbug, Uncle? You don't mean that, I'm sure.
Oh, but I do. Merry Christmas? What reason have you to be merry? You're poor enough.
Well, come then, what reason have you to be morose? You're rich enough.
Bah! Humbug.
Don't be cross, Uncle.
What else can I be? Out upon a Merry Christmas. If I could work my will, every idiot who goes about with Merry Christmas on his lips should be boiled in his own pudding and buried with a stake of holly through his heart.
Uncle!
Keep Christmas in your own way and let me keep it in mine.
Don't be angry, Uncle. Come, dine with us tomorrow.
Never. No, good afternoon.
I'm sorry with all my heart to find you so resolute. But I'll keep my Christmas humor to the last. So, a Merry Christmas, Uncle, and a Happy New Year.
Good afternoon.
And a Merry Christmas, Mr. Cratchit.
Merry Christmas, sir.
Good afternoon!
Scrooge and Marley's, I believe. Have I the pleasure of addressing Mr. Scrooge or Mr. Marley?
Mr. Marley's died 7 years ago this very night.
At this festive season of the year, Mr. Scrooge, a few of us are endeavouring to raise a fund to buy the poor some meat and drink and means of warmth.
But are there no prisons?
Plenty of prisons.
And the treadmill and the poor law, the union workhouses, they in full vigour then?
Both very busy.
Oh, I was afraid from what you said at first that something had occurred to stop them in their useful course. I don't make merry myself at Christmas, and I can't afford to make idle people merry. Yes, I know. You'll tell me that many can't go there, and many would rather die. Well, we'd better do that than decrease the surplus population. Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Good afternoon.
You'll want all day tomorrow, I suppose. Hmm?
If quite convenient, sir.
It's not convenient, and it's not fair. If I was to stop you half a crown for it, you'd think yourself ill-used, I'll be bound. Hmm? And yet you don't think me ill-used when I pay a day's wages for no work.
It's only once a year, sir.
Well, that's a poor excuse for picking a man's pocket every 25th of December. Be here all the earlier the next morning.
Even the blind man's dog knew old Scrooge and avoided him. Scrooge kept all humanity at a distance and liked it that way.
Jacob. Jacob Marley. Humbug. Humbug. What do you want with me?
March. You don't believe in me.
I don't. Because you may be an undigested bit of beef, a fragment of an underdone potato. There's more of gravy than of grave about you.
I wear the chain I forged in life. I made it link by link and yard by yard. I girded it on of my own free will. And of my own free will, I wore it.
Now, now, you were always a good man of business, Jacob.
Business! Mankind was my business. Why did I walk through crowds of fellow beings with my eyes turned down and never raise them to that blessed star which led the wise men to a poor abode? Hear me.
I will.
I am here tonight to warn you that you have yet a chance of escaping my fate, Ebenezer. You will be haunted by three spirits. Expect the first tomorrow when the bell tolls one. Expect the second on the next night at the same hour. The third upon the next night when the last stroke of 12 has ceased to vibrate.
The air was filled with moaning phantoms. Their misery was plainly that they had lost the power to interfere for good in human matters. So, Scrooge awoke to the chimes of a neighboring clock. His room was flooded with light, and a hand opened the curtains of his bed.
Are you the spirit, sir, whose coming was foretold to me?
I am.
Who and what are you?
I am the ghost of Christmas past.
Long past?
No, your past.
What brings you here?
Your welfare. Rise and walk with me.
Good heavens, I was a boy here.
Your lip is trembling.
What?
And what is that upon your cheek?
Nothing.
These are but shadows of the things that have been. They have no consciousness of us. The school is not quite deserted. A solitary child, neglected by his friends, is left there still.
A poor boy.
Let us see another Christmas. Do you know this place?
Know it? I was apprenticed here. It's old Fezziwig. It's Fezziwig, alive again.
Yo-ho, me boys. No more work tonight. Christmas Eve, Dick. Christmas, Ebenezer. Clear the way, me lads. Cheer up, Ebenezer. Merry Christmas to you. Hee-ho, me lad.
He was very much attached to me.
Welcome, everybody! Merry Christmas to you all!
A small matter to make these silly folks so full of gratitude.
Small?
Why, is it not? He has spent but a few pounds of your mortal money. 3 or 4, perhaps.
But it isn't that, Spirit. He had the power. He had the power to render us happy or unhappy. To make our service light or burdensome, of pleasure or of toil.
My time grows short. Quick.
You are changed. You fear the world too much.
There is nothing as hard as poverty, so I pursue wealth.
I have seen your nobler aspirations fall off one by one until the master passion, gain, engrosses you. Our contract is an old one. I can release you.
Have I ever sought release?
In words? No, never.
In what then?
In a changed nature, in an altered spirit. May you be happy in the life you have chosen.
Oh, spirit, why would you delight to torture me?
I told you these were shadows of the things that have been. That they are what they are. Do not blame me.
Take me back. Haunt me no longer.
Enter, Ebenezer Scrooge. Come in and know me better, man. I am the ghost of Christmas present. You have never seen the like of me before.
Spirit, conduct me where you will. If you have aught to teach me, well, let me profit by it.
Touch my robe.
As they walked, the spirit shed from his torch a few drops of good cheer on the passers-by. They stopped to bless the humble dwelling of the Cratchit family.
Hooray!
And how did little Tim behave?
As good as gold. He told me coming home that he hoped the people saw him in the church because he was a cripple. And it might be pleasant to them to remember upon Christmas Day.
Come on, Timmy.
Who made lame beggars walk and blind men see.
The little boy lost in the snow. The little boy lost in the snow.
Arthur.
A Merry Christmas to us all, my dears. God bless us.
God bless us, everyone.
God bless us.
God blesses everyone.
Spirit, tell me if Tiny Tim will live.
I see a vacant seat in the poor chimney corner and a crutch without an owner, carefully preserved.
No.
If these shadows remain unaltered by the future, the child will die.
No.
What then? If he be like to die, he had better do it.
Don't.
And decrease the surplus population. Oh, God. To hear the insect on the leaf pronouncing on the too much life among his hungry brothers in the dust.
What place is this?
A place where miners live, who labor in the bowels of the earth. But they know me. See?
God bless you, merry gentlemen. Let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day to save us all from Satan.
Save us all from Satan's power when we have gone astray.
Oh,
Uncle Scrooge. He's given us plenty of merriment, I'm sure. And it would be ungrateful not to drink his health. And I say, Uncle Scrooge.
Uncle Scrooge.
A Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year to the old man, whatever he is. He wouldn't take it from me, but may he have it nevertheless.
My life upon this globe is very brief. It ends tonight, at midnight.
Forgive me, but I see something strange.
Look here. Look, look, down here.
Spirit, are they yours?
They are man's, and they cling to me. This boy is ignorance. This girl is want. Beware them both, but most of all, beware this boy.
Have they no refuge? No resource?
Are there no prisons? Are there no workhouses?
Presence of the ghost of Christmas yet to come. You are about to show me shadows of things that have not happened, but will happen in the time before us. Is that so, Spirit? Ghost of the future, I fear you more than any specter I have seen, but as I know your purpose is to do me good, lead on. Lead on, Spirit.
Old Scratch has got his own at last, I hear. Why, what was the matter with him?
God knows. It's likely to be a very cheap funeral.
I don't mind going if a lunch is provided, but I must be fed.
Come into the parlour. Come into the parlour. Come into the parlour. Come on.
Open that bundle, old Joe.
What have we got here, buddy? These blankets. Bed curtains. You don't mean to say you took them down, rings and all, with him lying there?
Yes, I do. If he wanted to keep him after he was dead, why wasn't he natural in his lifetime?
It's a judgment on him.
Spirit, I see. Yet I do see. Oh, God, merciful heaven, what is this? Spirit, this is a fearful place. In leaving it, I'll not leave its lesson. Let us go. I understand you, and I would do it if I could, but I have not the power, Spirit, I have not the power. Let me see some tenderness connected with the death.
My little child. My little child.
Before I draw nearer to that stone to which you point, answer me one question. Are these the shadows of the things that will be, or are they shadows of the things that may be only? Am I the man who lay upon the bed? No, Spirit. No, no, no. Spirit, I'm not the man I was. Good Spirit, assure me that I may yet change these shadows you have shown me by an altered life. I will not shut out the lessons that they teach. No,
They're not torn down. Look, rings and all. Yes, I will live in the past, the present, and the future. Oh, Jacob Marley, heaven and the Christmas time be praised for this. I just don't know what to do. I don't know what day of the month it is. I don't know how long I've been among the spirits. I don't know anything.
Hello, hello. What's today?
Hey.
An intelligent boy. Oh, a remarkable boy. What's today, my fine young fellow?
Today? Christmas Day.
Oh, it's Christmas Day. It's Christmas Day. And I haven't missed it. The spirits have done it all in one night. Well, they can do anything they like. Of course they can. You know, I scarcely ever looked at it before, but it's a wonderful knocker. I'll send it to Bob Cratchit. And he shan't know who sends it. My dear sir, how do you do? A Merry Christmas to you, sir.
Mr. Scrooge.
Yes. Well, allow me to ask your pardon. Will you come and see me?
I will.
Oh, thank you. Bless you. Is your master at home?
Yes, sir. He's in the dining room along with mistress.
Thank you. I'll just go in myself. Fred.
Well, bless my soul. Come in, Uncle.
Come in, Uncle.
Hello. And what do you mean by coming here at this time of day?
I am very sorry, sir. It's only once a year, sir. It shall not be repeated. I was making rather merry yesterday, sir.
Now, I'll tell you what, my friend. I am not going to stand for this sort of thing any longer. And therefore, I am about to raise your salary. A Merry Christmas, Bob. A Merry Christmas. I will raise your salary, Bob, and endeavor to assist your struggling family. Mm-hmm. And we'll discuss your affairs this very afternoon, Bob.
Scrooge was better than his word. He did all he had promised and more. And to Tiny Tim, who did not die, he was a second father. It was said thereafter that Ebenezer Scrooge knew how to keep Christmas well, if any man alive possessed that knowledge.
The stone is flawed. If it is held up to the light in a certain way, the figure of a springing panther can be seen clearly.
Mm-hmm.
Is flawed. If it is held up to the light in a certain way, the figure of a springing panther can be seen clearly.
Yeah. I'm Chicago. I have my own kind of politics, my own kind of music, my sports teams, and when I laugh, the whole world grins. I have my own radio station, WGN. We go all day, we go all night. Anytime you want me, just tune in here or give me a call.
WGN Radio is Chicago.
Stop wriggling, Arthur. You're getting the garland in a twist.
Sorry, Morris. Nappy's giving me jip.
Doesn't your mum use Super Softies?
Super what?
New Super Softies from Sterling Health. Bigger, softer baby wipes with soothing lanolin to cleanse, protect and care for our skin. Better, Arthur?
On cloud nine, Morris.
New Super Softies with lanolin. Skin care for little cherubs.
Obviously, if the drawings are closer together, the ball will move slower. And when the drawings are further apart, the ball's moving faster. Here's a great way of showing the difference between timing and spacing. This coin takes 1 second to go across the screen. It's going across in even spacing. Now, let's take it across with uneven spacing. But it still goes across in 1 second. The same timing, but very different spacing. Now let's see them both together. And we see something very interesting. Although it doesn't look like it, they start at the same time and they end at the same time. This is the same bounce that we've seen before. A small hard ball. And here it is with its spacing positions. The spacing creates the feel of a small hard ball. Now here's a squashy cartoon one. And here it is with its spacing positions. Now this is a larger, slightly soft ball. And here it is with its spacing positions. Now this. We're just using a circle, but it's how we space those circles, how we cluster them that creates the illusion. In this case, a heavy bowling ball. Here's a light ping pong ball. We know it's light because of the timing and the spacing. This one weighs almost nothing at all. Now let's take out every other drawing, making it twice as fast. Let's try it with an object. Here's the arc that the pendulum will swing in, and here's the breakdown or passing position. Add in-betweens. This is what it looks like when you don't have an ease in or an ease out. Now we add a slight ease in and ease out both ends. And it's more convincing. Now we'll add in two more positions. Gives us a nice result. But four more positions gives us an even better result. And we get a really nice ease in and ease out. Let's do it with a finger. We're easing out of drawing one. Same thing, easing out of drawing one with more in-betweens. Now we're going to ease in to drawing five, cushion in. Now we'll ease in with more in-betweens added. Now we're going to ease out of the first position and ease in to the second position. We'll add in-betweens and it'll be even clearer. Arcs are beautiful to watch. Straight lines give power. A pendulum eases in and out and follows an arc. Not like this. How are we going to in between these positions? Do we join them up like this? Usually, we get something half-assed, something like this. Neither one thing nor another, because the in-betweener doesn't understand arcs. When we really wanted this. Just this lifting arm follows three arcs. The elbow, the wrist, and the tips of the fingers. Everything doesn't happen at once. Our generic mouse is going to move the hand, the head, and the tail at different speeds. This is why they developed separate little charts. Different charts for different parts. The nose is going down uneven. The finger goes down, easing out and easing in, uneven. Say the tail goes down, even. Each part has different spacing, but it all takes place in the same amount of time. They put different charts for different parts, so that everything didn't happen at the same rate. This loosened things up. We'll start again with our normal walk pattern. The passing position is just slightly higher. The down position will be slightly down, where we feel the weight, and the push-off is the up position, the highest point. Here it is. We get a wave pattern. Now we're going to use our invented walk method. Start with the same contact positions and add the passing position on an up. And it still gives us an acceptable feeling of weight. Now let's keep the same contact positions, but make the passing position the down. We get this. Now keep the same contact positions again, and let's be inventive with the passing position. Down and bent like a peanut. It works. This method opens the door for all kinds of invention. However, don't make cycles of head action in circles. It comes out like a pigeon. Same bird-like effect with the figure eight. So for safety, we tend to keep the head mass mostly straight up and down. But we should still be brave and try things. Here's a formula for a slow sneak. Start with the contacts. And it has a very interesting passing position, way out in front. This takes just under 1.5 seconds per step. Here are the spacing charts for the body and head, easing in and easing out. With actions this broad, we should really put it on ones. Let's do a faster sneak, 1 second per step. So we'll reduce the amount of action. Here comes another variation. Here's a sneak that we're going to make work. As he goes up, the belly goes down. Contact. The down, passing position with delayed belly. The up, next contact. keeping a slightly different profile from the first contact. Down again. Pass position with delayed belly. Also a slightly different profile from the previous passing position 3. The up, and back to 1. Here it is on 1s, giving us a sneak on 4s. There's too much action in too short a space of time. Put in single in-betweens. Gives you a sneak on 8s. Still too much action. Now put in 2 in-betweens. Gives you a sneak on 12s. It works. Now put in 3 in-betweens. Gives you a sneak on 16s. It's kind of slow, but it works. 12s is the best one. Here it is again. If this is a wheel with only 2 positions, it won't go around. It just flickers. Take 3 positions, and it will go around. So we start with a cartoon run on 3s. Here are 6 positions to take 2 steps. And here's a rabbit running on 3s. It's planned from the mid-air positions instead of the contacts. Here's the down, the up, the down, the up. Here's another run on 3s. This one is planned from the contacts, but unusually for a run, both these feet are never in the air at the same time. Now add arms. In this case, the passing positions for the arms are not on the same drawings as the passing positions for the body. Here's an interesting invention, which breaks the 3-position rule on a run. There are only 2 drawings for each step. This is because the figure's coming towards us, so we don't need to see the feet going around. They're going up and down like pistons. Our logo characters have different personalities, but they're all walking on 12s. I wanted the duck to be silly, so I gave him the silly arm swing and the unexpected hops. The rabbit is on the mobile phone. People on the phone tend to glide, no up and down. But to get some sense of weight, I put up and down on his bottom half, belly, and the legs. He's supposed to be a Hollywood executive. The stick man enters like a deck chair, unfolding itself. Everything unfolds and gradually comes into the rhythm of 12s, like the other creatures. Our 1920s-style rubber hose cat moves in circles and figure eights, but still walking on 12s. He's boneless until he stiffens, limb by limb, but he stays on 12s. This happy guy is two-dimensional, so all we have to work with are his feet. So we lift the knees up high, to slam the feet down on the beat. The sausage dog stretches like an accordion. His back end is trying to escape from his front end. But he gets it together when he comes back in, and he's on the beat.
all two reasons I left the North Pole. First, the fraught grass that with all the fruity flavors. Second, I ain't too hot on the ice, man.
Cresta, in five fruity flavors.
It's frothy, man.
Taste that makes Long Life the different beer. Given the choice, most people would rather enjoy a Long Life.
Ugh.